In this video, we will learn how to query data on databases in a KNIME workflow. Let's get into it. While you can read a full database table into KNIME Analytics Platform with the DB Reader node and then process the data in KNIME, the KNIME Database extension allows you to do even more. You can efficiently move the processing of data from the KNIME Analytics Platform, which runs locally, to a database server by using the dedicated database query nodes. This frees up execution resources available locally or on KNIME Business Hub. The reason is that database tables can be large. Reading full database tables into KNIME can take longer than querying and reading its aggregated and filtered version. Moreover, sometimes you don't even need to read data into KNIME. You might process a database table and directly write a new table back to the database. The database extension provides multiple nodes for querying database data, such as DB group by, DB row filter, DB joiner nodes, to name a few. Good news is that most of the time these node configurations resemble their data transformation counterparts, so in most cases you don't need to learn any new configurations. In the background, a database query node automatically builds an SQL query according to its configuration. Besides, each query node wraps the incoming SQL query into a subquery. Hence, you can use multiple query nodes to visually assemble complex SQL queries. As always in KNIME, you don't need to write the code neither to create a single query nor to combine them. Unlike with processing data in KNIME, when using query nodes, processing of data happens on a database and the data stays with the database until you read it into KNIME, for example, with the DB Reader node. However, for each query node, you can preview the table that the current query in this node would produce. Let's have a look at an example workflow. Here, the products and contracts data are stored in the H2 database tables. We want to get the information about the products with more than 10,000 contracts from the database. Instead of importing two whole database tables into KNIME, we can import the data that is already aggregated, filtered, and joined on the database. For that, we will create the following queries. First, to count contracts for each product. Second, to filter our products with less than 10,000 contracts. And third, to join the products table with the aggregated and filtered table with contract counts. Let's start by selecting two tables, products and contracts, in two DB table selector nodes. The DB table selector node, as a result, creates an SQL query that selects the whole table from a database and passes this query to the downstream query node. Now, let's query the contracts table to get aggregated and filtered contract data. First, we want to count the number of contracts for each product. You can do it with the DB group by node. Its configuration dialog is similar to the one of the group by node. You group by products. In the manual aggregation tab, you can select any column and the count function. Note that the available functions depend on a database. Alternatively, you can select add count option. Let's execute the node. Now, the DB group by node has generated an SQL query and added it on top of the SQL query generated by the DB table selector node. The resulting query will then group the table selected in the DB table selector accordingly. This query is then passed to the next node, the row filter. But you don't really have to understand the details about the generated SQL queries. You can fetch the first 100 rows and preview the data generated by the query in the node. You can see that all products except the two have at least 10,000 contracts. Next, let's filter out these two products. You can do it with the DB row filter node. Here, the configuration is different to a simple row filter node and allows you to combine multiple filtering conditions. First, select the column to filter by in this menu, contracts number in our case. Then, select the operator to create a filtering condition, in our case, greater than. The available operators for filtering depend on the column type. Finally, enter the filtering value, 10,000 in our case. For categorical columns, you can also use the Fetch Possible Values button for the values to appear in the drop-down menu. The filtering condition that you just built is shown here on the left. To add further conditions, you can click the Add Condition button. For example, let's create a condition to check that the products column value is not missing. Now you have two conditions and can decide whether a row is included if both conditions are true. You select AND as a condition group connection, or if at least one of them is true, then you select OR. You can also create nested condition groups by selecting a condition, clicking the Add Group button, and creating more conditions. Finally, let's apply the inner join operation to join the products information from the products table and the contracts count from our aggregated and filtered contracts table for the popular products. You can do it with the DB joiner node. This node's configuration dialog is also similar to its data transformation counterpart. We select the inner join mode, product names as the joining columns, specify the columns to be in the final table, and execute. In this video, you have learned how to query database data and create complex SQL queries without writing an SQL code with KNIME database extension.